This Mass is offered for the soul of Gail Califano. And we pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who adorn the sacred body of your church with the confession of holy martyrs, grant, we pray, that just as the glorious passion of St. Ignatius of Antioch, which we celebrate today, brought him eternal splendor, so it may be for us unending protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you were dead in your transgressions and sins, in which you once lived following the age of this world, following the ruler of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work in the disobedient. All of us once lived among them in the desires of our flesh, following the wishes of the flesh and the impulses, and we were by nature children of wrath, like the rest. But God, who is rich in mercy, because of the great love he had for us, even when we were dead in our transgressions, brought us to life with Christ. By grace you have been saved, raised us up with him, and seated us with him in the heavens in Christ Jesus, that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in his kindness to us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not from you, it is the gift of God. It is not from works, so no one may boast. For we are his handiwork, created in Christ Jesus for good works, that God has prepared in advance that we should live in them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord made us, we belong to him. The Lord made us, we belong to him. Sing joyfully to the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful song. The Lord made us, we belong to him. Know that the Lord is God. He made us, his we are, his people, the flock he tends. The Lord made us, we belong to him. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, his courts with praise. The Lord made us, we belong to him. Give thanks to him, bless his name, for he is good. The Lord, whose kindness endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. The Lord made us, we belong to him.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
From the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Someone in the crowd said to Jesus, "Teacher, tell my brother to share the inheritance with me." He replied to him, "Friend, who appointed me as your judge and arbitrator?" Then he said to the crowd, "Take care to guard against all greed, for though one may be rich, one's life does not consist of possessions." Then he told them a parable. There was a rich man whose land produced a bountiful harvest. He asked himself, "What shall I do? For I do not have space to store my harvest." And he said, "This is what I shall do. I shall tear down my barns and build larger ones. There I shall store all my grain and other goods. And I shall say to myself, 'Now, as for you, you have so many good things stored up for many years. Rest, eat, drink, be merry.' But God said to him, 'You fool, this night your life will be demanded of you, and the things you have prepared, to whom will they belong?' Thus will it be for the one who stores up treasure for himself, but is not rich in what matters to God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thus it will be for the one who stores up treasures for himself, but is not rich in what matters to God. The Lord made us, we belong to him. Today, the feast, we celebrate the memorial of St. Ignatius of Antioch, who himself was a disciple of St. John in the early church. He was bishop and martyr. And it was in the year 107 when the time of great persecution of the church, when Christians were told to either denounce Christ or die. St. Ignatius of Antioch, of course, would not. And when he was questioned by the Roman Emperor Trajan at the time, and Trajan said to him, "Who are you, you little devil, who is leading his people away from denouncing Christ, who is leading his people away from to protect them in the midst of these persecutions?" St. Ignatius of Antioch replied, "You cannot call someone a little devil who has God, who bears God within him." And what a beautiful response. St. Ignatius of Antioch was then certainly persecuted for his faith and martyred, received a martyr's death for his faith. He was devoured by lions in the Roman amphitheater. And there was apparently, as the story goes in the history of the saints, there was nothing left of his body after the lions had completely devoured him, only but a few bones. And those bones were then taken by the faithful followers, his faithful followers, and preserved in Rome until this day. But St. Ignatius of Antioch, again, reminds us that we bear Christ within us. We bear Christ within us. And the responsorial psalm that we prayed today, the Lord made us, we belong to God. This is a beautiful sense of citizenship, a beautiful sense of belonging. for so many of us who struggle to figure out where do they belong, where do we belong in life. So many people have such a sad sense of loneliness, of isolation, but we belong to Christ. We bear God within us. The Lord made us, we belong to Him. And so let us take refuge in that. Let us be blessed by that knowledge that the Lord is by our side, that we belong to a community of believers, that we belong to a group of faithful followers to Christ. May we have the same conviction of the early followers of Christ. May we have that same zeal for Christ. May we never denounce Christ or be tempted to denounce Christ. May we preach God at all times. May we always bear God within us. We stand now and offer our prayers to our Heavenly Father. We pray for all members of the church. May the wisdom of the Lord continue to guide our every action. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the poor. May God provide for their material needs and give them peace, comfort, and rest. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and religious life, that more young men and women may have the courage to serve God and His church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who have died marked with the sign of faith, in a special way for Gail Califano, for whom I offer this Mass, may God grant them eternal rest. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear the prayers which we bring before you, and answer them if they be in accord with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May this oblation and our homage be pleasing to you, O Lord, just as you accepted St. Ignatius, the wheat of Christ, made pure bread through his martyrdom and passion, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the blood of your blessed martyr, Ignatius of Antioch, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through your Son, Jesus Christ. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lord. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
The body of Christ, bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. May the heavenly bread we have received, O Lord, on the feast day of St. Ignatius renew us, we pray, and make us Christians in name and in deed. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I just want to make an announcement of thanks to the Polish apostolate of our diocese for adorning the altar with such beautiful flowers. The colors are of the Polish flag, and how beautiful they look here at the cathedral. Yesterday we were blessed to have the Polish apostolate come for a Polish Heritage Mass, and it was aired on NetTV if you were able to watch it at 3 p.m. yesterday, but we were so grateful for their presence and the presence of their visiting bishop and Bishop Witold, so we were very happy to have them, and I'm really grateful that that they donated those flowers as well to us and for us. So we give thanks to them today. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Together we pray, Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who roam about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Consider all.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. Let us pray. O God, who instructed the hearts of the faithful by the light of the Holy Spirit, grant us in the same Spirit to savor what is right and always rejoice in his consolation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. Lord Jesus Christ, who has glorified your mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary, immaculate from the first moment of her conception, grant that all who devoutly implore her protection on earth may eternally enjoy your presence in heaven. Lord Jesus Christ, who for the accomplishment of your greatest works have chosen the weak things of the world, that no flesh may glory in your sight, and who for a better and more widely diffused belief in the Immaculate Conception of your mother, have wished that the miraculous medal be manifested to St. Catherine Laboureille. Grant, we ask you, that filled with like humility, we may glorify this mystery by word and work. Amen. Immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of our Lord Jesus and our Mother, we have confidence in your powerful and never-failing intercession, manifested often through the miraculous medal. We, your loving and trustful children, ask you to obtain for us the graces and favors we ask during this novena, if they will be for the glory of God and the salvation of souls. You know, O Mary, how often our souls have been the sanctuaries of your Son, who hates iniquity. Obtain for us then a deep hatred of sin and that purity of heart, which will attach us to God alone, so that our every thought, word, and deed may tend to his greater glory. Obtain for us also a spirit of prayer and self-denial, that we may recover by penance what we have lost by sin, and at length attain to that blessed abode where you are the Queen of angels and of men. Amen. Our prayer to Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. Virgin, Mother of God, Mary Immaculate, we unite ourselves to thee under your title of Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal. May this medal be for each one of us a sure sign of your motherly affection for us, and a constant reminder of our filial duties toward you. While wearing it, may we be blessed by your loving protection and preserved in the grace of your Son. Most powerful Virgin, Mother of our Savior, keep us close to you every moment of our lives, so that like you, we may live and act according to the teaching and example of your Son. Obtain for us, your children, the grace of a happy death, so that in union with you, we may enjoy the happiness of heaven forever. Amen. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us who have recourse to thee. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen.